happening. No gunshots, but they getting.
Hey, what's up you guys? Craft Farms here, back again with another video. Sorry that it's been such a long time. I've just been extremely busy. Gonna try and get more videos out, but we'll have to see what happens. Today we are playing on Westridge Hills Edit. This is from Pain Mapping on Facebook. Been doing some playing on this off camera. And then decided to, I'm to the point where I would like to start recording. So we're going to go ahead and get started here. We'll head on over to the yard here and then get started. I will give you guys a tour of the equipment. And then we'll get started on some field work here. Pull up beside the shop here. Okay, so first off we have the Chevy Silverado, the 1990. Here we have the John Deere 2410 chisel plow, John Deere DN345 spreader, Meridian 990 Max fuel trailer. We have the pressure washer there. I have the placeable lime silo right there. Let's see, I think we need to open this shed door here. Yes. Here we have the Rostel Mash. Here we have the sunflower header for the combine, the corn header, and then the pickup header. Here we have John Deere 7200. What is this? 3, 6, 9, 12 row planter. Here we have a 8-meter seeder. I don't remember what brand it is. It's some weird brand. Here we have the Vector 410 combine. Brent 440 seed wagon. John Deere 4440. International. That's right, it doesn't say there. International S2600 grain truck, I believe is what it is. And then finally, the International 5488. And then, oh, there is one more piece of equipment back here. We have the Forsgrit, I think is how you say that, E303 Swather. So kind of starting off with some small stuff, older stuff. We need to buy a sprayer. I downloaded a few here. Yikes. Hoofta. Let's see, this is a Hagee, or not Hagee. I forget what brand that is now. It's not an actual Amazon. I remember that. So there's that one, or there's this old thing. I think we'll buy... See, I tested this one and it acted goofy. I didn't try that. This one is what we're going to get, though. So we don't need that right now, but we'll go ahead and we'll get that reset. Take a look at it. Hardy, that's what it is. There we go. Okay, so what we're going to do is we're going to spread... what do we need to do? We need to spread some lime on that field. So that's what we're going to go ahead and do. So we'll hook up to the DN spreader here. Bring up the HUD just to make sure that everything's gonna work a-okay. Phil, sweet, it is live. Sorry for all these notifications here. Got some stuff downloading from some different guidance pictures for some stuff. So we'll get this filled up and then we'll go ahead and spread that field. Grab a screenshot here. Although a little late, I guess I should have remembered to do that right away. Alright, so we'll go ahead and back on out of here. Actually, I need this. We'll head on over to our field. So far, I still only own the one field that start with, field 16. I have not purchased any other fields. So go ahead and get up here. And of course, GPS is not going to line up straight like I want it to. That sucks. Well then. So let's try and get this thing lined up. This is definitely not going to take very long to spray, that's for sure. Fill up that a little bit. That'll work. It's close enough. The ground will get some fertilizer, I guess. Whoa. Getting off track there. Ooh, yeah, I overspread there. Go ahead and hop out and grab a screenshot again. Get back to spreading. See, I swathed the wheat that was on this field and then picked it up with the pickup header. We got just a little over two grain truck loads off of here, so now we have 64,000 liters of wheat. I got rid of the potatoes and sugar beets. I did not get rid of wood chips though, but yeah. So then I found out the crop that I'm doing next, and that will be sunflowers, because $1,189 a ton at the train station, so I can make some good money off of that. So the first thing to buy will be a new another field, and I want to try and get field 17 there to the east of us. That would be a nice field to have. Jeez, this thing starts a ways back. So we'll go ahead and spread this, and then we'll spray some NPK, and then we'll cultivate. So I think the main goal for this episode will be to spread and spray. And then see where we are there once we get that done. Yeah, about three full passes and a fourth partial pass, and that's all that this is going to take. So yeah, what I'm going to try and do is try and when I get home get home from working is try and get a video recorded, edited, and get it uploaded and scheduled for the next day. So I'm going to try that, see how that works, and go from there. Guess we're going to go ahead and slide this over. I'd rather overlap than spread on area that does not need it. Like the grass, for example. Because that does not need to be spread with lime in any way, shape, or form. Although it still will, but it's not too much, I guess. Yeah, a lot of the mods here are public, some aren't. Like the Brent Seed Wagon is not public. Let's see what else. The John Deere is not. The pickup is not public. And then, the rest of it is. You know, it's out there someplace. You'll be able to find it. If you don't feel like finding it, I'm not finding it for you. Okay. So we'll go ahead and back this in. Screenshot. We'll get this unhooked. Then we'll go hook up to the sprayer and we'll get our NPK sprayed. See, I at first didn't realize that sunflowers were already on this map. So I was getting ready to add them myself and everything, and then I looked in the store and, oh, it's already on here. Guess I don't even have to. So that was kind of nice to know. Press mouse control. Oh, booms are adjustable. Cool. That's good to know. So get this filled up with some NPK. Okay, so we'll use the old course. We'll just have to resize or adjust, readjust the working width. This is the thing I really, really hate about this map is this huge hill. Really sucks. Okay, actually, I think maybe we don't even need GPS. Probably just do this without it. As long as it changes the color of the ground, I'm okay. Then I got this. So that is all the way down right there. There we go. Perfect. I don't know if I can do it from in cab. No, not quite. Can't quite see where I'm going. See, I haven't really done anything with mods lately, you know, in terms of working on them. Just haven't really felt like it, but I'm going to try and get back into it, try and get some stuff done. I've got like 3 or 4 mods that they just need to be in-game. They're ready to rock and roll. The Chandler 24 RDT tender, that's pretty much... that's pretty much ready to rock. I just need to do the dynamic fill plane cube and then script in-game that. My Circle J horse trailer, horse cattle trailer, that's ready to be in-gamed. I did kind of start on it. I kind of got some stuff set up for it. And then... my 82 Chevy C30, that's ready for in-gaming as well. Just got to get it all done. And in-gaming is my least favorite thing to do, so that's kind of why I put it off. And then I have a bunch of models, you know, from Polygonish and other models that, you know, I've started working on, like my Duo Lift cone bottom trailer. I started modeling that. I need to finish modeling that yet. There's a couple models that a guy put into one of the groups I'm in, that he said, you know, I haven't finished these. If you guys want to work on them, you can. And actually one of those was a Deutz, 1500, or it was a 1400, but it's pretty much the same as a 1500, chisel. So I'm doing a little bit of work to that, and then I'm going to AO it and then make it into my Alice Chalmers that I will have been planning to do for a while, and then also into a Deutz 1500 chisel. And then I still want to take the case, whatever, direct drill, and I still want to, the guy that made it, he actually figured out how to AO and did that, but I want to take it and redo some stuff on it and re-AO it and separate stuff, all that good stuff, and then just completely re-script it from the ground up. And stuff like that. And then I have a whole bunch of models and stuff that I just need to work on, but you know, just don't have the time or the want to do it, I guess. But yeah. And then my map, I've still been kind of playing around on it every once in a while, just kind of screwing around, just seeing what it's going to be like to farm on it. And you know, it is a very old version of the map, but you know, all the fields are going to be the same, so it just kind of gives me a general feel for, you know, what the terrain is like, what the fields are like, and all that stuff. And and then I had gone to test some stuff on a different, on, you know, the more updated version, and it just would crash the game, so I exported everything over to, you know, the same blank starter map, and just basically copied all the terrain, texture, whatnot files over, and all of that stuff, and then you know, just imported stuff, and then did some more work, and it works now. I did have some texture index issues, so all of the stuff that I exported that wasn't there already, all of that all of that stuff was white because I forgot to change all of the indexes on it. So so I went and did that, fixed that, and then I checked it out in game. Looks pretty good, so back to working on that. And need to get back to working on the buildings as well. Just another thing that I'm really dreading doing because it's going to be a long process, but it'll be all worth it in the end. So I don't know how much time we have left here. 10 minutes. Looks like we're going to cultivate then, I guess. This tractor is kind of the main workhorse, but yeah, it's kind of a beefier tractor. I definitely really like this 5488. Yeah, then I was going to try and get some video out over the weekend, but we went to the farm and sorted calves. And that were hauled off to the sale barn. Had two ground load trailers come in and haul two loads of calves away. It was roughly 120 calves. I think the first trailer had like 57 or something on it, and the second one I think had over maybe a little over 60 or 60 something like that. So the pH will go down when as fast forward time, so we'll have to put down some moisture and herbicide yet, so that'll be the project for next episode. So we'll just cultivate until the episode's over, or until we're done, whichever comes first. Yeah, so we went out about 8 in the morning and took the four-wheelers and Rangers and then a pickup. I took my uncle's four-wheeler, my dad had his four-wheeler, and then two other really good family friends came out. The one has his own four-wheeler out there, and then the other one drove the newer Ranger, and then my stepmom drove the older Ranger, and then my uncle was driving the pickup. We all headed over there. That was a cold ride early in the morning, but it was fun. I had to go cross up to the gravel and had to go on the gravel road a little ways to get to the pasture, to the far pasture, because there's like three or four sections all in one that the cows were kind of roaming around in, and went out and got them all home and kind of getting them right to where they needed to go, and then they decided to break loose, so it was kind of a crazy rush to try and block them off before they get out kind of thing. It was funny, me and my dad and my uncle and one other guy, we all went to the same spot where they were going, and got there, and then one happened to slip through, so my uncle went after it with the pickup, and he didn't manage to get it, but it was just a cow, so it really wasn't too big of a deal. We only needed the calves. But, and then finally got them all back to where they needed to go, and then got them all in, and then sat and sorted them by, ear tag color, and then, sorted them out into numbers of, groups of however many. It was groups of 16. The first group was purple, green, and yellow tags, and then the second group was all red, and then got them all into different pens, and then the one trailer came, so we loaded that one, and then the other one was taking a while, so we all went and ate, and then kind of sat and waited around for the second trailer. And it had taken a load that morning already, so it took a while for it to get there, and then when it got there, we got that one loaded and out it went. And then my uncle has had many Fords similar to, you know, mine. He's had like F-250s and stuff around the same year. And so I asked him if it was alright if I went and robbed a couple parts off of him for my truck. Went and got a new mirror from one of his pickups, and then went and got the cover underneath of the steering wheel from another one of his pickups, because there was two of them. The one, it didn't have the same mirrors, because it was a, it had, the one had like power windows and stuff and power mirrors and all that, so the mirrors were a lot different. But then the other one had, you know, the manual windows, so they were the same, or all the manual stuff, so the mirrors were the same. So then that took a little while to get off, and my dad had to come out and help me. Well, he came out to see, because it took a while to get the cover off under the steering wheel, and I thought maybe it was just like bolted someplace and I was missing it or something, and here I just wasn't pulling in the right spots because it was just kind of snapped in there. And then my cousins were there too, and I had the one, he was helping me, and then his sister, she was just kind of following us around, seeing what we were doing. And then she went back into the yard, and my dad asked how we were doing, and she's like, eh, okay, I guess. And he's like, well, do I need to go help him? I think so. So he came out to check on us and just got the cover off, and then I was like, well, you want to help me get that mirror off? And ended up needing to get a grinder and grind off the one bolt, because it had, like, you know, mine, it has all star bolts or star screws, whatever, on it. And then that one, it had one star and then one normal bolt, and the bolt just kind of sat and spun. So I had to go back into the yard and get a grinder and one of the cordless grinders, and then go back out. And yeah, there's a lot of trips back and forth, but got it all and got all the stuff on my pickup and was good to go. And it was a fun weekend overall. And then yesterday when I was driving home from working, was driving down the highway and all of a sudden started hearing this weird sound, and thought maybe because my driver's door is bent a little towards the top, so air kind of flows through it, and I put weather stripping in there, so now it has like a little area it goes through, so it kind of whistles. And I thought maybe, you know, the wind was just kind of going through the door weird. But then again, it didn't really sound like wind. But I just kept driving, and then all of a sudden my rear end kind of started sliding around on me. So I slowed down, and then there was an approach right ahead of me. And so I pulled in there, and sure enough, my driver's rear tire was just shredded. And luckily my uncle, who I'm working with, he was right behind me. So when he saw me pull over and turn my hazards on, he hit the brakes and backed up, and I was going to call him anyways because I knew he was behind me somewhere because we left, you know, about the same time. And then so I was going to call him and say, yeah, I'm pulled over up here, my tire blew. But he stopped and then got it changed and got the spare put on. So now it's parked for a little while. The only time I'm going to drive it now is in town until I buy new tires, because if I get a flat now, I'm kind of screwed, because I have my spare on there now. But yeah, it was, there is very little left of my old tire. I must have hit a nail, you know, somewhere along the line, and then it went flat and I didn't realize it and just kept driving and ended up shredding it. But luckily the rim, it looks fine. I don't see any bent spots or chips or anything like that. So that's good. But yeah, that was quite the experience. So I called my dad to tell him, and I was like, well, I know what I want for Christmas now. I want an impact drill for getting tires off easier. And it didn't help that I'm pretty sure the tires on that probably haven't come off since ever, really. So they were really, really tight. But got it off, got the new one on, and I also want to buy a new jack because the one that's there is old and kind of small. But so I think maybe we'll be able to finish. Yeah, we'll just finish. We'll just finish here. We don't have a whole lot left. We're just about done, so. Yeah, then kind of spend some time, because we sorted cows on Sunday, because the place that they were hauling, getting hauled to, the sales are on Monday, so we had everything hauled out Sunday, and we went up there Friday, and then Saturday we were kind of just messing around, doing a bunch of different things, you know, cleaning out, there's a bunch of older garages kind of by the house, and there's a bunch of old stuff that's just been sitting there for ages that's, you know, never been gone through, and, you know, a bunch of old pipe and old, you know, a bunch of metal and all kinds of stuff just sitting there. And so we kind of spent the day going through all that stuff and, you know, figuring out what was garbage, what was scrap that could be hauled in, and then just kind of getting stuff parked away. Got lawnmowers parked and, parked the four-wheelers, but they, of course, got drug out again. You know, they weren't really parked away. And then just kind of got the yard organized and got a bunch of the tractors moved. And then my dad went out and stacked a few weeks ago when he was up there. He finished hauling all the hay home. So he was working on stacking it all, and he finished that on Saturday. I was doing some other stuff in the morning and didn't realize that he had actually gone out to stack bales. And then when he came in for lunch, went out with him and rode with him to stack the last, I think there's like a dozen bales or something like that. And then got that all finished, and then just kind of did an odd and end things, really. Just kind of pass the day away, do stuff that, you know, needed to be done for quite a while. And then, then on Sunday we got the cow-calf situation taken care of and headed home. Alright, so we just got a little bit left after this, and we are good to go. Dirt duration is set up for these 5488s. It must be quite a while. That or else this cultivator is just set pretty fast. One of the two. Alright, so we'll go ahead and start shutting this stuff down. Grab a screenshot as we go down the last pass. This stuff does not get dirty. Oh well. So we'll go ahead and finish this up, and then we'll wash the cultivator off, get it parked, and that'll be it. Jack does not have dirt at all. Alright, and that is a wrap. So I'll just kind of go over here, I guess. Fold, please. There we go. And we'll head to the yard. See, I'm thinking 17 probably would be a nice field. 17 or 10. One of the two, because they're close, and then the other's smaller, kind of, not really, but. What on earth? I don't know what just happened there. That was really weird. Anyhow, moving on. Okay, so that is going to do it for this video. If you enjoyed the video, make sure to hit that thumbs up button. If you're new to the channel, welcome to the channel. Make sure to subscribe if you like what you see. Make sure to turn on the post notifications to be notified every time that I upload a new video. Check out down below for PC specs, video schedule, but I'm not sticking to that right now. Links to social medias, my mod site, and other cool YouTube channels that are worth taking a look at. Thank you for watching, and I will see you guys in the next video.